Right. The combined lecture today of 8C and 8D. So 8D, I think already have done chapter number 3 revision yesterday. You have done now. So we people are going to revise chapter 3 tomorrow. Okay, so that the common can be common revision can be there. So I'm going to start with chapter 4 today. 8C, chapter 3 I will discuss tomorrow. Okay, because today is the combined lecture and already they have done chapter 3 yesterday, right? So let's start with the chapter 4 revision today. So open chapter number 4 from your book, page number 36. Okay, so let's start. The screen is visible to all. Is it properly visible, last boy? Okay, what is a table? What is a table? Anshika, unmute.
Yes, ma'am.
What is a table?
A table is an intersection of rows and columns. It is the basic object of database.
Anyone else? What is a table? A table is a database object in which you are going to store the data in the form of rows and columns. So write down the question, be quick. The questions for Photoshop now. Yes, you have written the questions during the revision time. So write down the questions. What is a table? A table is a database object that is used to define the data or used to store the information in the form of rows and columns. Yes, tables are the fundamental building blocks of the unit. So it helps you to store the data in the organized form, in the structured form. With the help of table, we can organize our data properly. We can store our data in the proper structured manner. Okay. What are data types? Yes, what are data types? Anyone? Yes, anyone? You can unmute and give answer, bachche.
A data type determines the type of the values that can be stored in under it.
Data type defines the type of the data that you can store. The kind of the data that allows you to store, which type of data you want to store. So it is used to declare the fields of a table. Data types are used to declare a field of a table. It defines the type of the data a field can accept, a field can store. That what kind of data a particular field will store, it will primarily depends upon the type of data type you are using. Now name various data types in a Yes. Yes, anyone from the online? Any online student?
Text, number, date and time, auto number, yes, no. Rich text, attachment.
So, data types are text, number, memo, OLE, date and time, auto number, yes, no, hyperlink, lookup, these are. Which data type is used to store the text or the combination of text or number? Text data type is used to store a text or a combination of text or number. The maximum characters the text data type can store? It can store up to 255 characters. The maximum of 255 characters. What is number data type? Yes. Data that can be manipulated, or the field which is just allowed to store only the numbers. No text can be stored, only the numeric data can be stored. That is a number data type. The maximum size of this field can be 16 bytes. Hanji Raghbir, number data type can store up to how many maximum characters? That is 16 bytes maximum it can store the data. And the text can store up to 255 characters. Learn it right now. You are present in the class now, so you are for the revision here. So learn it. Text data type is for storing the text or alphanumeric data. It can maximally store up to 255 characters. The number data type can store up to 16 bytes, right? Two data types are clear. Learn side by side, everyone. Next is memo. It is used to store the descriptions, and it helpful in storing the numbers as well as the text data. So both alphanumeric data can be stored in the memo. The size, it can be up to 65536 characters, right? The maximum size is 65536 characters. Learn the value. 65536 characters. The memo data type can store up to 65536 characters. Noted? Everyone noted, bachche? Next, which data type is used to store date or time? Date or time data type. You will not write date or its oblique sign. Okay, so you have to properly write the structure of the data type, that is date oblique time. It can be used up to how many characters or bytes? 8 bytes. So maximum storage is 8 bytes. No, it's a subjective test, PDF format. Okay, the next one is which data type is used to generate a sequential numbers whenever a new record is added to a table or turn number. So which data type is helpful in adding a record automatically once the new number is or new record is added? That is the auto number. Auto number. So auto number can store up to 4 byte values. It can store up to 4 bytes. How many bytes in the auto number? 4 bytes. Very good. Only offline students are answering. Online student ne koi answer nahi kar raha. Anji Jayant. Next, which type is used to allow to store only one possible value? Yes or no? The value can either be true or it can be false. So you can store only one value at a time. That is a yes or no data type. Okay. On or off, you can say yes or no. A student is a male or a female. So this kind of information where only one possible value can be entered. So that will be the yes or no data type. All right. Next is OLE. OLE stands for? Yes, online.
Object linking and embedding.
Object linking and embedding. Vedanti, kya ho gaya? Aaj answers nahi kar rahe ho. Which data type is used to embed an object created in another application? OLE. The data type that is used to embed an object created in another application such as Word, Excel, right? Any picture file or any table. So that is the OLE data type. It can store up to 2 GB of data. OLE can store up to 2 GB of data. Which data type is used to store links to the web pages? Hyperlinks. The links of the web pages can be stored in the hyperlink data type. It can store up to
1 GB of data.
Of data. The hyperlinks can store up to 1 GB of data. Right? What are lookup wizards? Lookup wizards means where a set of values can be, you have to choose it from the list. A list of defined values will be there. According to your choice, you have to choose from the list. Which data type is used to attach images?
Attachments.
Data type that is used to show the calculated values. Calculated. In which data type a combination of text and numbers can be formatted? The formatting can be done. The font colors can be given.
Rich text.
All the data types are clear. Any doubt? You have to learn the meanings, the descriptions of every data type for the one word along with the maximum storage. Kis data type mein kitni storage allowed hai, so you have to learn that particular figure number. Okay? Object linking and embedding. OLE stands for object linking and embedding. So this topic is clear. Any doubt in the data types to anyone?
And what is rich text?
Rich text data type, jahan pe aap whatever the text you are entering into the fields that can be formatted, on which you can apply the formatting. You can change the font colors, right? So that is the rich text data type. Name the views of a table. The two views of a table are design view, data sheet view, the view in which you can create or you can view your table. So you can view your table in two views. The views are design view, data sheet view. What is design view? A, C and D में से सिर्फ दो बच्चों को ही आंसर आते हैं, that is only from the offline. A, 3 and A, C students, online students, what they are doing? You don't know the answers?
Design view is used to format the table.
You can unmute yourself to answer. मैंने सबको permit किया हुआ है unmute करने के लिए. Jayant, don't raise hand. You can just unmute and give the answer if you know it.
Ma'am, I have a doubt.
हाँ जी.
Ma'am, what are the spellings of embedding?
Spellings of
embedding.
E M B E double D I N G embedding. E M B E double G I N G. Okay. Okay. So the two views are design view and data sheet view. The design view is a view which is helpful in creating the structure of a table, where you can define the structure of a table. Structure of a table means what fields you are going to store in the table. What kind of data that field will particularly store, and the description of the field can be given. So it will have three columns: field names, field data type, and the description. So it will allows you to define the field name, data types, and the properties. You can define the properties also. So design view is divided into how many parts? The design
two parts.
Write down the question. Design view is divided into how many parts? Two parts. Design view is divided into two parts, that is field grid pane, field properties pane. Field grid pane, field properties pane. Field grid pane, field properties pane. What is the use of field grid pane?
It defines field name, data type, and
description. You can define the field name, their data type, and the description of the field. So three things can be defined inside the field grid pane: field names, data types of the fields, and the description regarding the field, that what kind of data they are going to store. Okay, the second part of the design view is field properties pane, where the properties for the field will be defined. We have to set the properties, or you can define the properties of a particular field. So whatever field you are going to select, the properties related to that field will appear at the bottom part, right? So the two windows of the design view are field grid view, field grid pane, field properties pane. Okay, the second one is the data sheet view, the actual view where you are going to enter the data in a table. So data sheet view helps us to enter the data in a table. Any doubt till now? The questions are clear, the answers, right? Which shortcut key is used to save the changes and close the table?
Control plus W.
Control plus W is the shortcut key for saving the changes and closing the table. How you can switch between the views? What are the methods by which you can shift from one view to another? Right now we
have group views option.
Design view and data sheet view. Now can we change the view from data sheet to design or design to data sheet? So yes, we have different methods with the help of which you can shift your view. First one is home tab, views group, view option. Home tab, views group, view option. So you can switch between the desired view. Under the view option, you can see the two views will be appearing, design view and data sheet view. So you can choose any view in which you want to shift. All right, the second method is you can directly click on design view or data sheet view button that is present at the right side of the status bar. So view buttons are available on the right side of the status bar as well. Status bar ke right side pe do buttons aate hain views ke. You can directly click on a particular view in which you want to shift. Design view and data sheet view. Both the methods are clear. Written. Yes, Ragbir. Next, what are the ways by which the table can be created? Three methods or three ways are there by which the table can be created using design view,
data,
using
the tables, group and tables option.
Templates. So you can use any method by which the table can be created in SAS, design view, data sheet view, or templates. The command when you want to create a table in the design view, the command is create tab, tables group, table design option. You can note down the command. Create tab, tables group, table design option. Create a tables group, table design option. The command when you are working on the data sheet view, create a tables group, table option. Design view se create karoge to table design option aayegi. Otherwise, you can have the option table directly. Any doubt, bachche? From template, it is clearly mentioned when you have to create a database. At that time, when we click on the blank database, right? So, aap wahan pe, instead of creating the blank database, you can directly click on the template option. So, aapke paas ek predefined ready-made table will be there. So, you can opt for that also. Jo pehle do methods hai, hum apna khud ka table create kar rahe hain. Template means any underlined or predefined tables will be there. Okay? The difference is clear between the three. तीनों में क्लियर है एवरीवन. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज मेथड्स और वेज फॉर सेविंग द डेटाबेस और टेबल. आइदर यू हैव टू सेव अ डेटाबेस और यू वांट टू सेव अ टेबल. द मेथड्स विल बी सेम इन बोथ केसेस. यू कैन यूज द शॉर्टकट की कंट्रोल प्लस एस. द शॉर्टकट की इज कंट्रोल प्लस एस. कमांड इज File tab, save option. File tab, save option. Third method, save button on the quick access toolbar. Save button on quick access toolbar. Three methods, launch. Speak out the methods, yes, who will tell? Online students.
File tab, save option.
Save button on quick access toolbar, control plus S. Which key is used to move to the next cell in a table?
Tab key.
Key used to shift or used to move to the next cell in a table. एक सेल से दूसरे सेल में आप जाना चाहते हो टेबल के अंदर द की विल बी टैब की एंड व्हेन यू वांट टू मूव प्रीवियस फ्रॉम वन सेल टू अनदर बैकवर्ड डायरेक्शन में जाओगे तो
शिफ्ट प्लस टैब की
शॉर्टकट की विल बी शिफ्ट प्लस टैब की. व्हाट इज प्राइमरी की? Yes, what is primary key?
A primary key is a sort of check that identifies each record in a table.
A key that helps you to define the each record uniquely. When you want to uniquely define any record in a table, aapko identify karna unique record ko, that is primary key. So primary key basically means unique plus Not null. Unique मतलब उसमें कोई भी duplicate data नहीं होगा. That field will have only single record in that. Plus not null means you cannot make that field empty. आप उसको खाली नहीं रख सकते. It is compulsory to fill the data in that particular field. जिसको भी आप primary key बनाओगे, that field will have some data, but that should be unique. That should not have any repetitive or duplicate value. Okay. So primary key is a sort of check which will uniquely define or uniquely identify each record in a table. The command for the primary key is design tab tools group primary key option. This is the first method. This is the command. You can opt for the second method. Right click on a field name and choose primary key option. Any method you can choose for making a field as a primary key. Either follow the command or either you can directly right click on a particular field and choose a primary key field. कैसे पता चलता है आपको field primary key बन चुका है? A golden color key is there on a field. आपके field के ऊपर एक particular symbol आ जाता है key का, that will help you to identify that this field is a primary key field. How to add new record in a table? Record means you want to enter new data. Simply you can start typing in the new row. That was the simplest method, the direct method. Simply typing, start typing in the new row. Second method, the command, home tab, records group, new option. Home tab, records group, new option. Or you can click on the new record button on the record navigation bar. Click on new record button on the navigation bar. The three methods are clear. Written even on page number 39 also. The command is given on page number 40. Now, once the record has been added, how you can edit that? How you can modify that? आप उसको modify कैसे करते हो? Change कैसे करोगे? Yes.
Click on the field and start typing.
Click on the field and start writing. तो वो new तो नहीं आपका
double click on the cell where we want to make the changes.
ऑलरेडी द डेटा इज सिलेक्टेड, अगर आप उस पे डायरेक्टली टाइप करना स्टार्ट करेंगे तो प्रीवियस वन विल गेट लॉस्ट, ठीक है. एंड इफ यू वांट टू एडिट अ पर्टिकुलर वन फील्ड, आपको पूरा नहीं ओमिट करना, सिंपली डबल क्लिक ऑन द सेल, बिकॉज़ द डेटा इज स्टोर्ड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ रोज एंड कॉलम ना, तो वो क्या है, सेल्स ही है. आपको जिस सेल का कंटेंट चेंज करना है सिंपली डबल क्लिक ऑन दैट, अ कर्सर विल अपीयर, देन यू कैन टाइप अ न्यू डेटा, यू कैन एडिट द डेटा. Okay, so double click on the cell that you want to edit and simply a cursor will appear, type the new data that whatever you want to edit. What is field property?
An attribute that defines the field's appearance within a database.
Tell the fields behavior, that what kind of property we are want to set. So that can be set in the field properties area. Where does it appear? Field properties kahan se set kar sakte hain? We have just studied right now. Field properties set karte hain. Design view mein. डिजाइन व्यू के कौन से पार्ट में?
फील्ड प्रॉपर्टीज पे.
फील्ड प्रॉपर्टीज पे अभी हमने डिस्कस नहीं किया. डिजाइन ग्रिड के दो पार्ट्स हैं, फील्ड ग्रिड पेन एंड फील्ड प्रॉपर्टीज पेन. फील्ड ग्रिड पेन में आप फील्ड नेम डिसाइड करते हो, फील्ड प्रॉपर्टीज पेन में प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ अ फील्ड विल बी डिफाइंड. अभी देखो कुछ ही मिनट हुए हैं और आप लोग भूल गए हो. How to add new field? So you can add a new field, a new column in the data sheet view, also in the design view. So both the methods are there. Either you can do addition in design view or in the data sheet view. So data sheet view mein the method is right click on a particular field where you want to insert and choose insert field option. Right click and choose insert field option. डिजाइन व्यू में डिजाइन टैब, टूल्स ग्रुप, इंसर्ट रोज ऑप्शन. कॉलम इंसर्ट करने के लिए भी वहां पे ऑप्शन क्या आ रहा है? इंसर्ट रोज ऑप्शन. ओके, क्लियर. हाउ टू डिलीट अ फील्ड? अगेन यू कैन डिलीट अ फील्ड इन डिजाइन व्यू एज वेल एज इन डेटा शीट व्यू. तो डिजाइन व्यू में डिजाइन टैब, टूल्स ग्रुप, डिलीट रोज. एड में क्या आ रहा था? इंसर्ट रोज. डिलीट में क्या आएगा? डिलीट रोज. द टैब एंड ग्रुप विल बी सेम. ओके, डिजाइन टैब, टूल्स ग्रुप, इंसर्ट रोज. डिजाइन टैब, टूल्स ग्रुप, डिलीट रोज. इन डेटा शीट व्यू राइट क्लिक ऑन द फील्ड वेयर एवर यू वॉन्ट टू चूज, दिस इज अगेन द सेम मेथड. वहां पे ऑप्शन आता है इंसर्ट फील्ड ऑप्शन. And in order to delete, the option is delete field option. But the method is same. Data sheet ka method bhi same hai, design view ka method bhi same hai, only the option is changed. Insert rows, delete rows. Insert field, delete field. Right? Any doubt, bachche? Clear hai? Aap koi bhi method use kar sakte ho. What is sorting? What is sorting? Sorting means arranging the data. You can arrange the data either in ascending order or in descending order. We can arrange the data either in ascending order or in descending order. So in a sense, we can sort the data by the command home tab, sort and filter group, ascending or descending option. Home tab, sort and filter group, ascending or descending option. The second method is you can click on the drop down arrow of a particular field. Field ke upar click karoge drop down pe, there will be options choose sort smallest to largest or sort largest to smallest. So aap ye method bhi use kar sakte ho. And how to remove the sort? How you can remove the sort? Home tab, sort and filter group, remove sort button. Home tab, sort and filter group, remove sort button. Write down the command, remove sort button. Okay. How to hide or unhide? Right click on the field that you want to hide. Choose the option, hide field. जिसको भी hide करना है, right click करके hide field. Unhide करना है तो unhide field. The same option, method is same. You have to just change the option. Yes, बच्चे which command?
Now to sort data.
Home tab, sort and filter group, ascending or descending option. और जब आपने रिमूव करनी है होम टैब सॉर्ट एंड फिल्टर ग्रुप रिमूव सॉर्ट बटन क्लियर. दिस कंप्लीट्स अवर चैप्टर नंबर 4.
यस मैम.
हाँ जी बच्चे, हाइड करने के लिए राइट क्लिक करना है एंड यू हैव टू चूज द ऑप्शन हाइड फील्ड. अगर आपको अनहाइड करना है, हाइड फील्ड को राइट क्लिक करके अनहाइड field option. Okay, that's all for the today. So do revise this chapter again in the evening so that all the question and all the queries can be fixed out. Okay, see you tomorrow. Take care, bacha.